In this short tutorial, I would like to show you how you can work with text to make it sort of kinetic, to make some title openers or some simple openers for your videos. It's really easy as you know how to go about this, and I'll show you step by step how you can approach creating such an animation. Let's go! Hello and welcome in today's tutorial. Now let me show you how I would go about this. I would create a new composition, and this would be a rather short composition. I would change the duration to about 3 seconds. Okay, I have my 3 seconds, so I would try to create the text in the middle. I would select my text tool, I would click the text, and I would write, for example, let's go. Now I have to customize the text. So I want this to be of equal sizes, a rectangle. So I just take the go, and let's of course make it bigger. Don't worry about the spacing, because the spacing can be adjusted in this place. You can go for automatic or adjust it like that. All right, I think we are prepared, and this time we will activate the 3D for our layer, because I want to work a bit with the rotations. Let me also open the title action save. You should do the same. You should take the move tool and place the text in the middle. Well, this text is too big. Let me make it smaller. And I don't like that the anchor point is on the left side. So select Y on your keyboard, take the anchor point and try to place it around the middle. Okay, this will be better now. I go back to my selection tool, I click on the text, and now I'll work in the timeline. At first I want it to be much, much smaller. This is like my final result. Now I open up the rotation. And since we have 3D activated, I have the X axis, Y axis, and also the Z axis, which is great if you want some freedom with this. Maybe the animation will end at 1 second and 10 frames, and I want it to be slightly shifted. So I'll work with my Y rotation, and I'll set it to 20 degrees. Okay, I don't need the title action save, I think, anymore. And this is like the end screen you want to achieve. So I'll set a keyframe here. It will come from the bottom, and it will rotate a little more. So I need to select Shift and P. So we also have the position to work with. Now I'll work with the second position. Let's keyframe the position at the end point here. Let's go to the beginning, and at the beginning it should come from bottom. So I'll select my Y value, and I'll place the Y value like this. Okay, can you see it? The next thing you want to adjust is the Y rotation. So you should have a stronger rotation here, because we want it to rotate in. You can see it on the screen. I'll just freestyle here, 70 degrees, that's okay, and you should have about this animation. Okay, very nice. I also want the scale to be working for me, because now it's too static. So once again, select the text, press Shift, and press Scale. Now the scale will be up to you, and as I told you, this is the end result, here are those keyframes, so I'll also set the scale like this. But a bit earlier, the scale should be bigger. So I'll just take the scale and I'll up it to about 90%. As I see it now, I should have the position made a bit more to the bottom. Okay, so we have an animation like that. Boom. Of course, well, the scale comes in too quick, because I wanted it to be visible on the screen, rotate a little bit, and then to be a bit smaller. Like it has a rounded movement. Okay, let's say that I've adjusted all the keyframes, so I select all of them, I right click keyframe assistant, and I ease them in. Now I would like to separately adjust them, because I want the position, the scale to work a bit different, the Y rotation. If you have those 6 keyframes and you ease them in, press on the position and press on the graph editor. Now the graph editor, if it looks like that, it will be okay. You can click here, you can change between the speed graph and the value graph. Now on the speed, I want this animation to start off really quickly. And to visualize, this will be quickly and then it will be slower. So you have to pull the handles either like that or the second one to the left side. And you can now imagine, this is a speed graph, and the speed here will be 1500 pixels a second at the top speed. So it will be really quick, like the entire composition in 1 second. But then it will slowly fade to the place where it should stay. Boom. Okay, now you see the scaling looks a bit weird, so we need to adjust the scaling. We have already the position, click on scale, and let me think about what should be done here. Well, I do like that it goes linear. Maybe those keyframes are a bit too close to each other, so I'll place the keyframe more to the left. And you just have to work around with this. You just have to hit space, maybe slower at the beginning, boom, space. And watch the screen. I think the scaling now works perfectly, because around here, which is exactly here, it starts to scale down. So from here to the middle, it will scale down to about what we had, 60% or something like this. And the motion looks really fluent. I do like the look of this animation. You can press on the Y rotation, and if you would like the rotation, for example, to happen maybe slower at the beginning, like this, and then a bit quicker, so at the end it will flip to the right place, you could adjust it, but this is completely up to you. Look how it will change. Boom. You see, this doesn't look as cool, so I'll go back with it. I think this was the okay amount. All right, I have everything prepared, and maybe the animation should fly out on the top of the screen and my video would start playing. So I do not want to make this tutorial longer, but what I would do to finish this animation is I would set a nil object, I would parent the nil object to this original layer, I would press P like position, and I would fade this off to the top. So I would select a keyframe here, then I would go forward, I would place it over the top like this, so it would like boom, boom. Maybe it was too quick. I would of course need to adjust those keyframes. You get the idea. Maybe this should be later, because the text should stay on the screen a little bit, and you would have an animation like that. And if you would like to have more speed on it, you also press S, like scale. You maybe unlink the scale and watch what you can do. As it unfolds to the top, you will make a keyframe at the beginning of the scale. Then at the end, let's say that this is the end, it will gain speed by making it longer and narrower. Okay, this is how you can eventually imitate speed. Of course, those keyframes would need to be adjusted, but you would get an animation like this. The text is a little bit distorted and it gains speed and velocity as it progresses. With just a simple adjustment to the position, so the position will go quicker at the beginning, I receive an animation like that. It comes into play and it nicely fades off to the top. I do hope that you did like this tutorial. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.